മൊഡ്യൂൾ 4 സെക്കൻഡ് ലെക്ചർ ഓൺ കോംപ്ലക്സ് ഇൻ്റഗ്രേഷൻ. സോ ഇൻ ദിസ് ലെക്ചർ വി വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് സെക്കൻഡ് ഇവാലുവേഷൻ പ്രോബ്ലംസ് കെറ്റ് യു ഡിസംബർ 2016 ആൻഡ് കെറ്റ് യു മെയ് 2019 ടു പ്രോബ്ലംസ്. ദി സെക്കൻഡ് ഇവാലുവേഷൻ മെത്തേഡ് ഈസ് വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ്. സോ ഇൻ എവറി എക്സാം ദർ മസ്റ്റ് ബി എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഫ്രം ദിസ് പോർഷൻ. So I already discussed in last video what is second evaluation method and all. So we will directly do the problem. So the first problem is evaluate integral over C. Evaluate integral over C, real part of Z dz, where C is a straight line from 0 to 1 plus 2y. Okay, so the first thing is we will, our curve C is a straight line from 0 to 1 plus 2y. So first we will draw the curve. Okay, so this is 0, 0 to 1 plus 2y means the straight line joining 0, 0 and 1, 2. Okay, so 1, so this is our curve. This orientation must be positive. So this is our curve 0, 0 and 1, 2. So first we will find the parametric equation for the line segment joining 0, 0 and 1, 2. So C is line segment joining 0, 0 and 1, 2. So the equation is, so we will write C, Z of t is equal to 1 minus t, 0, 0, plus t into 1, 2. Okay, and always here the range is 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. This is only for line segment joining two points. Okay, so this is equal to 0, 0 plus t plus, sorry, t, 2t. So this is t, 2t. You add both. Okay. Now, therefore, Z of t is equal to, in the place of x, this is t. So t plus I, 2t. 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. Now we will find what is z dash of t. This is derivative of this. Okay, so 1 plus with respect to t, 1 plus 1 I into 2. So this is derivative. Therefore dz is equal to 1 plus 2i dt. So we want to integrate. Our integrand is real part of z. So we know that z is always x plus iy. Then real part of z is x. So we will integrate this. Integral over c, real part of z dz is equal to integral over c, real part is x dz. Now we will convert it. We already know that what is integral over c f of z dz. This is the formula is integral a to b. If c range c is z of t equal to x of t plus I y of t, a less than or equal to t less than or equal to b is our curve, then integral a to b f of z of t into z dash of t d. So this is our formula. Okay. Okay. So here this is equal to integral 0 to 1. So this ranges from 0 to 1. Real part of, so this is x. So what is x here? So We know that z of t is of the form x of t plus I y of t. So x is here t and y is here 2t. Okay, so here x instead of x we can write t into dz is 1 plus 2i dt. 1 plus 2i dt. So this is equal to, we can write 1 plus 2i outside, that is a constant, integral 0 to 1 t dt is equal to 1 plus 2i into integral t is t square by 2 0 to 1. So this is 1 plus 2i into 1 by 2. So this is the answer, that is equal to 1 by 2 plus i. So this is very simple. The thing is, you have to first identify what is the equation, parametric equation for the curve C. If it is line segment, we can use this method, and then you convert all in terms of t, and then we will do the problem. Now I will do the second problem. The second problem, okay, and this is evaluate integral over c z bar all square. This is z bar all square, that is conjugate of z bar all square dz along. First one is okay. ഇപ്പൊ കേക്കാവോ? So this is a two part okay, so this is our question. Evaluate integral 0 to 2 plus I z bar all square dz along this line 2y is equal to x. Okay, so our curve C is 2y 2y equal to x, and we have to integrate from 0 to 2 plus I. So first we will draw the, so what is C is a line in 2y equal to x, or y equal to x by 2. So that must be in this line, y equal to x by 2. Okay. Now, from where we have to integrate from 0 to 2 plus I, 0. This is 0, 0. And we have to integrate from 0 to 2 plus I. So 1, 2. Okay. Right. So we have to integrate. This is the line segment 2i. 2y. Okay. So here we have already given the equation of the line segment, that means 2y equal to x. Either we can find the equation by using the formula for this 2y equation of this line segment joining 0, 0 and 2i. But here already we have given. And now what we have to do? We just have to find out the parametric form. So here 2y equal to x. Now I am putting x equal to t. Then what is y? Y equal to x by 2, which is equal to t by 2. And so c is x equal to t. So this is the parametric form, y equal to t by 2. And it ranges from 0, 0 to 2, 1. So here x ranges from 0 to 2. So x ranges from the starting point of x is 0 and ending. So x ranges from 0 to 2. So what is x? X is t. So we want to from where t evidenna evidam vare range cheyunu pakshe t endana t x aanu appo x inde x evidenna evidam vare range cheyunu 0 to 2 so this is 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 2 so our c z of t is equal to z of t is equal to x t plus I t by 2 where 0 less than or equal to t less than. So so here we can we already given the equation of the line. Okay, so it's very easy to find, or otherwise it you will give only the line segment joining 0 to y, then you can use that vector equation. നമ്മൾ പ്രീവിയസ് പ്രോബ്ലത്തിൽ ചെയ്ത പോലെ ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇതേ ആൻസർ കിട്ടും. ഓക്കെ, സോ നൗ ഹിയർ യു ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് സെഡ് ഡാഷ് ഓഫ് ടി 1 പ്ലസ് ഐ ബൈ 2. സോ ടി സെഡ് ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 1 പ്ലസ് ഐ ബൈ 2 ഡി. ഓക്കെ, നൗ we have z equal to x plus iy, and we know that z bar equal to x minus iy. Now we want to find out z bar all square. This is equal to, if you multiply this x plus x minus iy into x minus iy, you will get x square minus y square. Minus into minus plus iy all square is minus y square. Okay, plus you will get minus 2i xy. So this is the z bar all square. Okay, so now we want to find out the integral 0 to 2 0 to the point is 0 to 2 plus I z bar all square dz is equal to integral 0 to 2 plus I z bar square is x square minus y square minus 2 I xy into dz. Now we will use parametric form. So we have t ranges from 0 to 2. So 0 to what is x here in the place of x is equal to t, x equal to t, and y equal to t by 2. So x square is t square minus y is t by 2 all square minus 2i into x t into t by 2. Now dz is 1 plus I by 2 dt. Okay, so now this is equal to integral 0 to 2 t square minus t square by 4 minus 2 and 2 get cancelled. I t square into 1 plus I by 2 dt. So now we will simplify this 0 to 2. If you multiply this, you will get a t square minus t square by 4 minus I t square plus t square into I by 2 I t square by 2 minus I by 2 into t square by 4 minus I t square into I by 2 d. Okay. So this is equal to integral 0 to 2. T square by minus t square by 2 is 3 t square by 4. 3 by 4 t square. And we will take real parts. Okay. So here there is I, and this is minus I square I into t square into I by 2. So that is equal to plus I into I minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 into minus plus. So plus t square by 2 dt. I am splitting I into 0 to 2. This is minus t square plus t square by 2 minus t square by 8 dt. So this is equal to if you integrate this 3 by 4 t cube by 3 plus this is 0 to 2. Again, if you integrate this, you will get t cube by 6 0 to 2 plus I times integral. So I'm integrating this minus t square t cube by minus t cube by 3 plus plus t cube t square by 2 is t cube by 6. Screen. Okay. 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 Minus. Now, if you integrate this with respect to t, you will get a t cube by 24. Right? Okay. So, sorry. 0 to 2. Now, if you simplify this, you will get the answer. I'm not doing this calculation. So, what we done is, here in this question, it's already given the equation for the line segment. Okay, so we can directly how to find out z of t parametric form. Here y equal to 2y equal to x is given. So you simply put x equal to t, then you will get y equal to t by 2. So that is, then you will get the parametric equation directly, t plus I t by 2. Now if you want to find the limit where from where to where t ranges, so here our t 0 0 to 2 1. So here x ranges from 0 to 2 and y ranges from 0 to 1. So x, we are taken x equal to t, therefore t ranges from 0 to 2. Now in this case, we have 2y equal to x. If you taken y equal to t, then x must be equal to 2t. You can take any ഐദർ എനിവേ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു തരത്തിൽ എടുത്താൽ മതി. ഓക്കെ, അങ്ങനെയാണെങ്കിൽ സെഡ് ഓഫ് ടി എന്താവും? ടു ടി ഐ പ്ലസ് സോറി ടു ടി പ്ലസ് ഐ ടി. ആ കേസിൽ നമ്മുടെ റേഞ്ച് മാറും. റേഞ്ച് എന്താവും? വൈ ആണ് ടി ആയിട്ട് എടുത്തത്. ഓക്കെ, വൈ ആണ് ടി ആയിട്ട് എടുത്തത്. അപ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ വൈ റേഞ്ചസ് ഫ്രം സീറോ ടു വൺ ആണ്. അപ്പം എന്തായിരിക്കും? ടി റേഞ്ചസ് ഫ്രം സീറോ ടു വൺ. സൊ യു ക്യാൻ ടേക്ക് ഇൻ എനി മാനർ. എനി ഇഫ് യു ഹാവ് ഗിവൺ ഓൺലി ദി ലൈൻ സെഗ്മെന്റ് ജോയിനിങ് സീറോ സീറോ ടു ടു വൺ സോറി ടു വൺ, ദെൻ യു യൂസ് ദി ദിസ് ഇക്വേഷൻ ലൈക്ക് സീറോ സീറോ വൺ മൈനസ് ടി ഇൻറ്റു സീറോ സീറോ പ്ലസ് ടി ഇൻറ്റു ടു വൺ. So you will get the z of t, and if you use this equation, then always t ranges from 0 to 1. If you use this equation, t ranges from 0 to 1. So we completed this portion. Now next is Cauchy integral theorem. So this is very important theorem, and so this is very important theorem. And before that, I will define what is simple closed path. A simple closed path that does not intersect or touch itself as shown in the figure. For example, a circle is simple because or this. If you take this is a simple closed path, okay, so it doesn't intersect itself or touches itself, right? So, or if you take a circle, this is a simple closed path. If you take an ellipse, it's a simple closed path, there is no intersection. Now if you take this, this is a simple closed path. But this is not simple because there is an intersection, it touch itself. And this is not also a simple closed path, there is intersection. Okay. Now, so simple path, closed path, you just think about a circle. Okay, circle is a simple closed path that doesn't intersect by itself. Now, a simply connected domain D in a complex plane. Now, we will define what is simply connected domain. In the complex plane is a domain such that every simple closed path in D encloses only points of D. That means if you what is a domain? Domain is a simple connected open connected subset of a subset of complex plane. Suppose this is a domain D, this is a subset of complex plane. So this is called simply connected. If you draw any simple closed curve inside this, then ee closed curve in the inside illa points endayirikkanam domain il undayirikkum. Anganeyanengile adine simple closed curve nu parayum. Okay, for example, I will show you an example. So for example, if you take this domain, this is simply connected domain, because if you draw any simple closed curve in this domain, if you take any point inside, that point must be a point of this domain, right? So if you draw this is a simple closed curve, and if you take any point, this point must be a point of domain. This is also simple closed curve. If you take any simple closed path, and if you take any point inside this, this point must be a point. But this is not simply connected, because if I draw a simple closed path here, and inside this simple closed path, if I take a point here, ee point endana ee simple closed path inde agathulla point. But this point is not in this domain. So this is not a simple closed curve. And one of the important example is if you take entire complex plane, see, this is simply connected. Simply connected, because entire complex plane, if you take any closed curve, that is, if you take any point inside that closed curve, that must be in the complex plane. So entire complex plane is always simply connected. Okay, so in നമ്മുടെ പ്രോബ്ലം ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ എപ്പോഴും എൻ്റെ ഒരു കോംപ്ലക്സ് പ്ലെയിൻ ആണ് മോസ്റ്റ് കേസ് ദേ വിൽ ഗിവ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ സോ നൗ വി വിൽ ഡിഫൈൻ വാട്ട് ഈസ് വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് തിയറം, കോഷി ഇൻ്റഗ്രൽ തിയറം. ഇഫ് എഫ് ഓഫ് സെഡ് ഈസ് അനലറ്റിക് ഇൻ എ സിംപ്ലി കണക്റ്റഡ് ഡൊമെയ്ൻ, ഓക്കെ, യൂഷ്വലി ദേ വിൽ ഗിവ് സി സി. ഇഫ് ഇഫ് ഡൊമെയിൻ ഈസ് നോട്ട് ഗിവൺ, then we will consider it as domain as C, entire complex plane. So the theorem tells us if f of z is analytic in a simply connected domain D, then every simple closed path C in D, integral over C f of z dz is equal to 0. So we doesn't want to find the parametric representation of a curve. So what we have to do, only if it f of z, we have to check whether f of z is analytic, and if analytic, and if our curve is a simple closed curve, then the function integral must be equal to 0. Okay, so that means if you have a simple closed, you just check whether it is a simple closed curve, and whether if our curve is a simple closed curve, you have to check whether f of z is analytic inside this curve. If you take any points inside this, f of z must be analytic. So we will do some example, then you can easily understand. So we already know that e raised to z, cos z, sin z, all such functions are and polynomials are analytic everywhere. A function which is analytic everywhere in the complex plane is called entire function. Function which is analytic everywhere is called entire function. Now if you take suppose C be any closed path, then we have integral over C e raised to z dz. C is any closed path. So here there is a domain is not given, so the domain must be entire complex plane. And if you have any simple closed path, then by Cauchy integral theorem we know that this integral must be equal to 0, because this is entire function or analytic everywhere. If you take any point inside the curve, the function must be analytic. Now similarly, cos z is also entire function, so the by Cauchy integral theorem this is 0, and z power n is a polynomial, this is an entire function. If you take any closed curve C, the function is analytic. Now we have to check whether non-entire function. So if you take integral over, so this is integral over C, 6z dz, okay, and our C is a unit circle. Okay, so this is a simple closed path. Now what is 6z? Integral over C 1 by cos z dz. Now this function is analytic everywhere except z equal to cos z equal to 0. So where is this function is not analytic? Only when 1 by cos z is not analytic at for all points such that cos z is equal to 0. So when is cos z is equal to 0? Cos z is equal to 0 when z equal to pi by 2 plus or minus pi by 2 plus or minus 3 pi by 2, etc. Now if you take a unit circle, this is our simple closed curve, and pi by 2 is outside unit circle, sorry, minus pi by 2 is outside, pi by 2 is outside, and all other points where cos z equal to 0 is outside the circle. So if you take any point inside the circle, the 1 by cos z is analytic everywhere inside unit circle. Cos z is 1 by cos z is analytic, or 6z is analytic everywhere inside unit circle. So the point of point which f of 6z is not analytic is outside. So for this closed curve, the every f of z is analytic everywhere inside this simple closed curve, then by Cauchy integral theorem, integral over c 6z dz is equal to 0. Okay, now if you take a bigger circle, that means if you take this circle, then integral over c 6, if this is c, 6z dz cannot be equal to 0, because you cannot apply this, because here pi by 2 f of z, this function 6z is not analytic pi by 2 and minus pi by 2 and pi by 2, that is inside the circle. So we cannot use Cauchy integral theorem. But if this is a unit circle, if you take any point inside, this is, so that's why, yeah. Now if you take this and unit circle, okay, so in last problem is, yes, so we have to find out a integral over c 1 pi z square plus 4 dz, where c is mod z equal to 1 unit circle. Now the first thing you have to check, you have to draw the circle, unit circle 1, okay, radius 1, circle with radius 1. Now 1 by z square plus 4 is not analytic when this denominator is 0, not analytic when z square plus 4 equal to 0, which implies z is equal to plus or minus 2i. Now you mark here, this is I minus I 2i is here, minus 2i is here, okay. So our points which are not f of z is not analytic is outside this circle, right? So what we can say, so the points which are not analytic, points at which f of z, this is, if you take this is f of z, this function is not analytic when z is plus or minus 2i, and that points are outside the circle, okay. Therefore what we can say, f of z is equal to 1 by z square plus 4 is analytic everywhere in C. That means C equal to mod z equal to 1. Therefore, by Cauchy integral theorem, integral over C 1 by z square plus 4 dz must be equal to 0. Now, if you take a bigger circle, say circle with radius 3, then this integral may not be equal to 0. So, integral, if you take bigger circle, then the points at which this is not analytic is inside the circle, then you cannot use this. But for mod z equal to 1, this is a small circle, and the points, that means the points at which this is not analytic is outside the circle, therefore the integral must be equal to 0.